tried seventh grade. We ended last week where I told you we would be doing the counting principle. Oftentimes, this is referred to as the fundamental counting principle, but in this book, it's just the counting principle. This is really simple. All you'll need is a calculator, be able to read carefully, and you can answer all of these problems. This is not very tricky. It leads into stuff, particularly like Algebra 2 and beyond, where you talk about things like permutations and combinations, and where the fundamental counting principle is the basis for all of that stuff. But we're going to keep it simple here. Just learn what it is and apply it in a very simple way. The counting principle basically says, and you can pause this video and read what it says here exactly. In layman's terms, if I can just kind of say it in a way that I think you will understand. The counting principle says that if you want to count the number of ways that something can happen, if you're doing like more than one choice, you just multiply the number of ways each individual thing can happen. Like I said, I tried to maybe make that easier for you to understand. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't, I don't know. But read the example here, okay? Again, I'm not gonna read this up here to you, but the example here. It says, if you can choose a shirt in 5 sizes and 7 colors, well then how many shirts are there gonna be? Well, there's 2 choices you could make here, a size and a color. How many options are there for each choice? 5 and 7. So the way you answer this is you multiply 5 times 7. 5 sizes, 7 colors, that's going to be a total of 35 different shirts. And that's the counting principle. The counting principle says you multiply them. This multiplication right here between the 5 and the 7, that's the application of the counting principle. Let's read example 3 here at the top of the next page that I've got a worksheet we'll do some together with. So we have a deli here, and they're offering sandwiches, and it wants to know how many different sandwiches can you order when you choose 1 bread and 1 meat. So you go over here and you look at the menu. I'm gonna kind of cover the answer here, even though it's right here by myself. You didn't see that. How many choices of a bread do we have? Rye, wheat, white, pita, and a wrap. That's 5 bread choices. How many deli meat choices do we have? Roast beef, turkey, ham, pastrami, salami, and liverwurst. That is 6 deli meat choices. So how many sandwiches can we make if we choose 1 bread and 1 meat? Well, you would do 5 times 6. 5 bread choices, 6 meat choices, there are 30 possible sandwiches. What if the manager adds chicken to the list of meats? So now instead of these 6 meats, we've now got 7 meats if we add chicken. How many different sandwiches are now available? Still the same 5 bread, 7 meats, 5 times 7, and now we have 35 sandwiches available. You know, you could see how this could begin to get complicated if you start thinking, well, what if I choose 2 meats? What if I'm allowed to choose 3 meats? What if I'm allowed to choose 4 meats? And then that's where we get into the more complex counting of things like I discussed a minute ago. But we're just keeping it simple. We're not doing problems like that. All right, let's close this up and look at this worksheet. So this is the worksheet that's going to be attached. Problems 1 and 2 say draw a tree diagram. That was last week. If you want to practice, go ahead. But we're going to come down here where it says use the fundamental counting principle to add the following problems. Answer the following problems. Pizza is always a famous counting principle problem because of the toppings and stuff. So here we go. A restaurant offers 4 sizes of pizza. 4 sizes of pizza. 2 types of crust. 8 toppings. How many possible combinations of pizza with 1 topping are there if you're only choosing 1 of the toppings? You are making 3 choices here, okay? Choice number 1 is what size? That's 4. We multiply that by choice number 2, which is what kind of crust we're gonna get. We got 2 of those. And choice number 3 is you're gonna pick 1 topping. We've got 8 of those. Multiply straight across. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 8 is there are 64 possible toppings. And that's the counting principle. So hopefully you find this easy. Let's keep going. How many ways can 5 paintings be lined up on a wall? You might be asking yourself, wait a minute, where are the choices I'm making here? Well, every time you pick a painting to hang it on the wall, you're making a choice, aren't you? So you're making 5 choices here. Imagine all 5 of these paintings are on the floor and you're about to hang them on the wall. So now it's time to decide which one are you gonna hang first? Well, you haven't hung any yet, so all 5 are available to you for that first choice. So now you've got 1 on the wall, and now you're making your second decision. how many paintings are left for you to make that second decision from? Well, one of them is already hanging on the wall, the first one, so now there's only four left on the floor to choose from. Now you make your third decision. Which one's going on the wall? Two are already hanging, there's three on the floor left to choose from. Now you're making your fourth decision. Three are already on the wall, and there's two left for you on the floor to make your decision from. And when you make your final decision, it's no decision at all because there's only one painting left. And this is how many different ways you can line up five paintings on a wall. 5 times 4 is 20, 20 times 3 is 60, 60 times 2 is 120, 120 ways. So that was kind of like a little disguised counting principle. Alrighty, I think what we'll do here is we will answer maybe 3 and 4, and I'll give you 5, 6, and 7 for homework. How's that sound? Grace loves to eat salad. How many salads can she put together if she can choose from one of each of the following? 2 types of lettuce, 4 types of vegetables, 7 types of dressing. 2 times 4 times 7. Use your calculator if you need it. 56 different salads. There you go. Number 4, you go to Best Buy to purchase a new TV. That's one of the more fun things you'll ever do in life is buy a new TV because it's just like an exciting thing. So you have the following choices: LCD or plasma. So LCD or plasma. Screen sizes: 27, 32, 36, 41, 51, 63. And manufacturer: Sony, Vizio, or Philips. How many different televisions does the store have? First choice, LCD or plasma. That's 2 options. Second choice, the size: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different sizes. 6 options. Third choice, manufacturer: Sony, Vizio, Philips. That's 3 options. 2 times 6 is 12. 12 times 3 is 36 TVs. Alrighty, so we will give you 5, 6, and 7 here. 5 is about a lock that has 4 dials. 6 is a website used to set up an account, password protected. Password format is 4 letters followed by a single number. So how many possible passwords are there? So that's going to be 5 options. 4 different letters and then 1 number. And then lastly is a license plate problem. In one, you can repeat the numbers, and in the other, you can't repeat the numbers. And this letter B right here is going to be similar to this painting one where the numbers decrease, okay? So, short and sweet video for you guys this week. I think we've only got one more to go next week, 7th grade, and then the year's going to be over. Have a great week. As always, reach out if you have any questions, comments, concerns, email, the chat on Teams, however you like, and I'll get back to you. All right, guys, thanks. Running through emotions high and low, holding on or letting go. I'm fighting another day. Neon lights in the fast lane, life riding high, reaching for